Hi, my friends, it's Ro. So many of you guys have been asking me how to stay fit during quarantine while gyms are closed. You're afraid even when gyms reopen to go back to the gym because you don't want to share germs and that kind of stuff. I'm kind of in the same boat. I don't know what I'm going to do moving forward. And I've been kind of dragging my feet on making this video because when I do make health and wellness and fitness videos, you guys tend to not watch them. Maybe it'll be different now because of quarantine, but if you like this content, give this video a thumbs up so I know to make more of it. And without wasting any more time, here's what I've been doing and what you can do to stay in shape and healthy during quarantine or anytime moving forward, even afterwards. Welcome back. My name is Ro. I'm not going to waste any more time with an intro. If you want to know any of my experience and expertise and all that stuff, just go watch old videos. Not too old, because they're cringy in the beginning. But along with supporting people who have a loved one who's incarcerated, I also have another passion, which is health and wellness and fitness. And I used to be Miss Fitness New Jersey a whole bunch of years ago. Recently, up until the gyms have all been closed down for quarantine, I was working at a group training CrossFit gym. And I've kind of taken those workouts and morphed them a little bit for stuff that I could do at home with what I have access to, which is basically just my body weight, my living room if it's raining or too cold out. Still kind of on the chillier side in New Jersey. Adam, my loved one who's inside, has not had access to weights in over a decade, so he kind of helps me put together these workouts as well. So, first and foremost, your body is enough weight to get yourself into shape. Let's think about athletes that use their body as weight. Let's look at gymnasts. They are lean, they are cut, they are low in body fat, and they're muscular, and they don't lift weights. Everything they do is their own body weight. So you absolutely can get in shape. You can build muscle, you can lose fat on body weight alone. What I had in my house up until quarantine was I had a workout bench. It was like a long barbell, so I could take that off. I could do squats, I could do deadlifts, I could do bench presses. But my neighbor down the street is a college athlete, and he cannot get out of shape. He has a scholarship to a really good school. I lent him my bench because they had access to no weights. They were all sold out when this first started because people freaked out. Nobody can work out with weights and everybody thinks, oh my God, that's all I could do. So I said, absolutely take them. You need them. You're 20 years younger than me. Do your thing. I got this. So the exercises that I've been relying on are things that I can do with my own body as resistance. Push-ups, squats, lunges, mountain climbers, running, sprints. I use the staircase on my deck to do stair sprints. Adam sent me his warm-up that he does in about 7 minutes. It's a workout for me. I do it in about 17 to 20 usually. Now, I'm not suggesting that you do this. I suggest that you take this as a suggestion. I suggest that you take this as a suggestion. Okay, let's go with it. Change the numbers for your fitness level where you're at right now. So what he's been doing is 100 jumping jacks. Then he moves into 100 push-ups. Then he moves into 100 bodyweight squats. Then he moves into 100 mountain climbers. Then he moves into 100 bicycles with your abs. He does it 100, the next 100, the next 100, the next 100. And then after 2 weeks, he upped it to 120. I've been following along, but what I do is I'll do it in sets because I can't do more than 7 or 8 push-ups. Sometimes if I'm lucky on a really good day and I'm not sore, 12, and then I need a little bit of a break. So I do it in sets. Well, I'll do all of the 100 jumping jacks because for me, I'm in shape enough that I can handle that. Or sometimes I'll do jump rope because it's basically the same motion and I want a little bit of a change of pace, or I just want it to go faster. I'm really good at double unders on a jump rope. Then I will move into 25 push-ups, and then I will do the 100 squats broken up into maybe like 60, take a breath, and then 40. Then I'll do the 100 mountain climbers. Then I will do the mix of everything else, and I'll work the rest of the push-ups in between. So sorry, I said that wrong. I would do the 25 push-ups, 100 squats, 25 more push-ups, broken up into sets of probably 10 and then fives and then even singles if I have to. I also added what I call towel pulls because I felt like my whole front was getting a workout and my back wasn't. And then he wound up adding those as well. And I added glute bridges because I also want to focus on my lower body. When he went up to 120, I'm breaking a lot of it up into 60s. The whole point of me telling you how I do it differently from him is that I have to break it up for what works for me. So let's say you can only do 10 of everything, do 10 of everything for a week. Then next week do 12 of everything, and then you can move up. Pick one of the exercises and do it. Or what I was thinking about doing when I first started, because I'm working from home, every time I take a bathroom break, throw in 10 squats. You could do stuff like that. I'm also running around the neighborhood, socially distant. So if somebody's on one side of the street, I will politely cross the street if possible. Everybody has been very, very good about being polite, even though we kind of side-eye each other because everyone thinks they own the sidewalk. I also do a lot of burpees, a lot of jump rope. You can go on Amazon and you can get a jump rope for under $10. That's a great cheap piece of equipment that you could really use to get in shape. Think about boxers and how in shape they are. So basically all I'm trying to do is move my body every day, take a mix of movements and try to get in some cardiovascular conditioning. Now is a really good time to do that because we want to strengthen our lungs. We want to make sure we stay healthy, keep our immune systems operating optimally so we can avoid getting viruses and germs, especially the one we're in hiding from in the future. Working out is a way to stay healthy. It's a way to elongate your life. It's also a way to beat the boredom, and it's a way to do something constructive with this time that you have right now. You can do this in a few different ways, okay? You could just do steady state, which is you get out of the house, you go for a walk for 30 minutes, you go for a jog for 10, 15, 20, 30 minutes, whatever your fitness level is. Or you could do things like intervals. That's the way I love to train. It's gonna burn your fat off your body faster. So I like to do maybe sprint for 20, 30 seconds and then walk or just stop for 20 or 30 seconds. I'll do that a lot. There's a little hill on right in front of my house on top of my street. I'll sprint up that hill and then I'll walk back down and just up and down, 10 times, 4 times, just depending on my mood. There's a street right around my house that is a mile all the way around. It's a loop. So sometimes I'll just run that a couple times and that's my workout. Sometimes I'll run up and down the stairs 4 or 5 times, or I'll run 5 sets of stairs, do 5 or 10 squats, and then just repeat that for 10 minutes. Pick the exercises that you like, do them for a few minutes a day and feel healthy. That's what this is about. It's not about torturing yourself. It's not about beating yourself up. That's something that I've been really trying to do as well. Right before this quarantine, I was going to the gym an average of once a week, max twice a week. I was paying to go a lot of money to go every single day of the week if I wanted to. I had an unlimited membership, but I had gotten myself to the point where I would actually get really anxious about these really, really hard workouts and I wouldn't want to go. Even though every time I went, I loved it. It was hard doing it, but then afterwards you get all those endorphins. It's awesome. It's wonderful. But I was just like, I would get into my head before. So what I'm trying to do now and what I want to pass along to you guys is kind of use this time as a reset or a recharge or getting back into it, because most of us by adulthood have tried some form of working out, eating right, exercising, some form, something, whether it be swimming when you were a kid or playing Red Rover with your friends when you were a kid and then you stopped. Everybody has tried something and we stop for a reason, whether it be because we got too busy or because it's just too much and we don't like it. Use this point to find what you like to do again. Turn on some music and dance in your living room. Girl, that's a workout, let me tell you. Go outside and do some jumping jacks. I had a 2-hour workout the other day because I was bored and I was just doing different things, but I was just breaking a sweat. I was not dripping. I was just having fun with it. And that's what I want to pass along to you guys now, is that I want you to get back to a point, even if it takes you 6 months, where you're doing things that are fun for you so you're not dreading it. And then when things open up, or when you're ready to take that next step and you're actually looking forward to a workout and you want somebody to write something for you, then I will have more for you. But in the meantime, find what works for you. Are you enjoying sprints in your backyard? Are you enjoying stairs? I love running stairs. Are you enjoying jumping rope? Are you enjoying more the push-up type of stuff, the pull-up type of stuff, the ab workouts? You don't have to be a fitness model by tomorrow. You don't have to drop 10 pounds in a week or a month. Why don't we work on taking all of those ideals, usually unrealistic ideals, off of us and just getting back to the basics of moving our bodies, building our immune systems through a fit, healthy body, just by starting by moving it, and then we'll build upon that. We'll go from there. No beating ourselves up, no negative self-talk. I am letting you guys off the hook and saying you could pick some of these exercises that I shared with you. You could just pick something on your own. You can open up the front door and you can go for a walk. That's it. That's all I want from you guys. So if you're down, let me know. If you want me to do more workouts in the future, let me know. I do have a collab coming up with a girl who's just like me. She's fit, competes in fitness, and her husband's also inside. So look out for that. But in the meantime, I just want you to get in the swing, in the flow of moving your body a couple times a week.
Close till I get up, time is barely on our side. I don't wanna waste.
Okay, let me know in the comments below what you decide to do. Give me a thumbs up. If you guys wanna go through an actual workout with me that I did that Adam sent to me, click on that video right there. And also, if you're not a subscriber yet, why aren't you? Click that right there, and I'll see you guys in the next one.